I'm excited to kick off the season finale of this round of Little Big Updates. For those who don't know, Little Big Updates is a Figma campaign that features a ton of small but impactful product improvements. These updates come from an accumulation of user feedback. Yes, users just like you, that our teams gather and log throughout the year. They then block out several weeks to fix and polish those features. This is a collective effort by our product, engineering, and design teams that we all get really excited about sharing. And this time we have come up with not just a few, but 42 total updates. If you followed along with our previous LBUs, this marks our biggest one ever. We're also so excited to share these little updates with you today that include some truly big ones, which we hope will make your day-to-day Figma experience that much more smooth and efficient. Joining me today, we have Figmates, Katie, Rashawn, Jessica, Tim, Noah, Bursable, and Chia, who are brilliant engineers, product managers, and designers that are excited to share some Little Big Update love with you all. All of our Twitter handles are listed under our name, so be sure to show them some appreciation on the socials. All right. So, if you follow Figma on social media, you know that we've already dropped 21 Little Big Updates so far. In case you miss any, I'm gonna lead us on a quick journey down memory lane past all the improvements that are now already live. So this is gonna be a quick refresher. You know, hopefully you don't mind the speed, but you know, we wanna get to the new ones. All right, in week one, we introduced a bundle of asset panel improvements to help you better access and add component instances to your files, whether they're local or from a shared library. So number one, filter results lets you quickly find what you need. Number two, better thumbnails helps you see the details of each asset that you have in that panel. Number three, we added component details in the panel, like number of variants a component may have. And number four, this was the shining element of that week. It's a new component modal where clicking on an asset will open it up and it displays a larger preview and link to the main component file. And if you have a professional plan and up, you'll also see a component playground where you can preview and interact with any of the variants or component properties. You can even set variable modes before inserting an instance. That was just week one. Week two, y'all were most psyched about number five, video and FigJam. And what that allows you to do is take any MOV or MP4 file and just drop it right into your FigJam and it'll play just like that. We also had embed improvements like the Spotify and YouTube embeds when you drop a link. Number seven there allowed you to change the camera that you're using with the photo booth widget. Number eight was an emoji picker upgrade, allowing you to emote a little bit better with those that you're collaborating with. And number nine allows you to pick up where you left off when someone else is sharing what they see with you. So those were week two, a lot of collaboration updates. Week three was more design editor updates. We had select and copy from version history. So now you can more easily just copy an element when you go to a previous iteration and just paste it somewhere else. I know that y'all absolutely love this one. Number 11, got a little bit ahead of there myself. Number 11, copy link is now available in the quick actions menu. And what that means is if you're not on Figma desktop, it allows you to copy the link to your file that much more quickly. Number 12, we have improved paste link treatment, so it's a little bit easier for you to paste those links. And then we also had better multiplier export settings. These are deep cuts, but were really big improvements for those who experienced those pain points. Week four, we had design editor updates. The biggest one that week was offset measurements, which allows you to select an object and see the measurements for offset, horizontal, and vertical sides of those objects. We also had consistent click target for removing effects so it doesn't shift around on you. We added an auto layout min and max indicator improvement, as well as giving you all the ability to add arrow ligatures in your sections and frame titles. Big shout out to the Interfont for doing a lot of heavy lifting on that one. And finally, in week five, we dropped an update that allows you to use two new blend modes in Figma. That is number 18 that allows you to use the plus lighter or plus darker blend modes. If you're designing for iOS, I know that y'all were waiting for that one. Number 19 Oh, I'm breathing here. We have scrubbable inputs for color picker values. Number 20, we had parse alpha in color hex code inputs. And what that means is if you have an 8-digit hex code, it'll acknowledge that alpha input for you. Finally, it was great to see that one come. Number 21 was my personal favorite, outline glyphs separately. So then this way, when you outline stroke of your text and it breaks out those characters, each one of those characters is its own object. Now, that was the first 5 weeks, and we are going to move on to the new ones that are dropping today. We would love to hear in the chat which of the ones I just mentioned was most impactful for you. Take a moment and let us know. So we're going to be moving on. We're going to be introducing the new ones. This is the moment y'all have been waiting for. Now that we've revisited all of the ones that we've launched, it's the main event. We're unveiling the newest Little Big updates. We have 21 new ones for you that span the Figma Design Editor, collaboration workflows, and prototyping. To take us through our first round of updates to the Figma Design Editor, I'm going to pass the mic to Katie Dillon. Katie, take it away.
Thanks, Maggie. Excited to be here. As Maggie said, my name is Katie Dillon, and I am a software engineer working on the Figma Design Editor, zooming in from New York City. I work on text and vector elements in Figma, so to kick us off with number 22, I am going to live demo on Canvas Mock Previews. So you might have noticed a little bit ago, we launched a refresh of the font picker, and on Canvas live previews were a really heavily requested feature, so here they are. Additionally, we've added on-canvas previews for styles and font sizes as well. So that is exciting here. Okay, moving on to number 23, tab to autocorrect typos. So now when you have a typo in your text, you can just tab to autocorrect, and it will correct with the first suggestion that would have been in the right click context menu. We make no promises on what your spell checker decides to put there, so if you need to, you can always Command-Z to undo. Okay, last but not least, we know that SF Pro symbols are really important to some of you in your work streams. And they were rendering properly on the canvas, but they weren't rendering properly in the layers panel. So this is a small update that allows them to render properly in the layers panel, as well as frame names, and also in the components panel. So your SF symbols should be rendering correctly everywhere. So that's it for the live demos. Once again, font picker on Canvas previews, tab to autocorrect typos, and SF symbols rendering correctly. Okay, rolling on over into 25, we have snap on text box resize, and 26, which is snap on container resize. So here you'll see a target snap appear on the bottom of a text box to help you satisfyingly center the text box around your text. This works when resizing from the top or the bottom, with text aligned to the bottom or center. We apply a similar treatment to snapping on container size, which will help you center frames and sections to where their children are centered with another satisfying snap. Number 27 is select text in view only mode. It's a fun and helpful one. Now when a user is in view only mode, they'll be able to select the text on the canvas and copy it. And last of the updates for me on the editor is number 28, which were some updates to text shaping. Changing colors or other font properties within a word would previously result in some wonky behavior. Arabic text would use the incorrect contextual letter forms, and kerning pairs or contextual cursive fonts will no longer break now when colors are updated within a word. And this one was a really tricky one. So it was a fun one. All right. I'm going to pass it off to Roshan for our last one in the editor category, number 29, update to nested components properties.
Thanks, Katie. My name is Roshan. I'm an engineer on the DevTools team, zooming in from London. And Little Big update number 29 is that we've made nested component properties visible in both the asset panel's component modal that you're seeing here, and for my engineers on the next slide, in dev mode's component playground. Previously, only the parent component was visible, but now you can see everything. And that's it for me, Mickey. Back to you.
These are awesome. Katie, Rashan, thank you so much for sharing. I'm totally going to start naming my layers now, knowing that I can use Apple San Francisco symbols. It's a great incentive to like organize my Figma files properly. All right, folks, let's hear from another Figmate, Jessica Leary, product manager on the feedback team. Jessica is going to kick off our bundle of little big updates focused on helping you collaborate better in both Figma and FigJam. Take it away, Jess.
Thanks, Mickey. I'm super excited to be here. I'm product manager coming to you from Texas today, and I'm really excited to show you these features that will make collaborating with your team even better. First, I'm going to start us off with an exciting one, number 30, where we've added visual media to comments. As you probably know, a picture is worth 1,000 words, and now instead of having to write out your answers or responses in comments, you can include an image. So in response to this comment, I'm going to let folks know Eevee is my favorite Pokemon, and I'm going to include an image that people can reference, adding a little bit of extra, you know, flavor and color to how you express yourself and your team. Next up, we have emoji reactions to comments as another way to complete how you express yourself when you're communicating as a team. When you're responding or replying to people, you can now choose from a full suite of emojis to communicate how you're feeling. With this one, I'm feeling super excited about LBU, and so I'm going to do the heart face so people can get how I'm really feeling about things. Next up, we have nominate someone to spotlight. This is really exciting because now you can request another file collaborator to spotlight themselves so that you can more easily follow along as they present in case they may have forgotten or got started and forgot to spotlight themselves. As you can see here, you can request the person spotlight themselves, and then on the other end, they see a nice friendly nudge to kind of follow along and start the spotlight. And with that, I am going to pass it over to Tim. I'm going to nominate him to spotlight himself.
Thanks, Jessica. My name is Tim, and I'm a software engineer on the FigJam team, calling in from San Francisco. And I'm excited to talk through number 33, mind maps in FigJam. With mind maps, you can brainstorm and ideate quickly and easily without having to manually create and connect shapes, text, or stickies in FigJam. Adding new ideas is just a click, and FigJam will keep your ideas organized as you go. Mind maps are not live just yet, but we'll be rolling out in a couple of weeks, so keep a lookout. Next, I'll pass it to Noah with number 34.
Thanks so much, Tim. Hey, I'm Noah. I'm a software engineer on the mobile team, and I'm calling in from beautiful Berkeley, California. Little big update number 34 is a redesign of Figma's mobile app. Find and collaborate on recent files and prototypes while on the go with a brand new streamlined home screen experience in Figma's mobile apps. Next, I want to hand it to Bersabel.
Thanks, Noah. Hey, everyone. My name is Bersabel. I'm a PM based in the San Francisco Bay Area, and I work on our developer platform and integrations. So updates 35 and 36 are both improvements to widgets, and I'm super excited to tell you about them. So the Asana widget helps you import projects into FigJam and Figma to track the status of work as a team. But if you have a portfolio of Asana projects that you want to keep up to date on together, previously, you had to import each one by one. But now with update 35, you can import all the projects from an Asana portfolio all at once. And update 36 brings an improvement to the Jira widget. So the Jira widget helps you import Jira issues into FigJam and Figma to triage and plan work with your team. But previously, when you imported Jira issues, we didn't include any images in issue descriptions, which we know are important for understanding the full context of that issue. And so now we do. We include images in descriptions. All right, phew. That concludes the collaboration bundle of updates. Mickey, I'll send it back to you.
Thank you, Bersabel, Noah, Tim, and Jessica. The visual media and comments is an absolute game changer. When I started playing around with that, I added an image just for my clipboard, and I was like, whoa, it just works. And then I clicked on it, and I was able to zoom and pan around. And like, I don't know, it's a huge update, more so than just like, you know, like a little big update. But yeah, now to take us home with some truly awesome updates, we've got Chia presenting our last six features. We're down to the last six. How wild is that? Chia, take it away.
Thank you, Maggie. I'm really excited to close out this awesome list of little big updates. My name is Chia. I'm a designer on the prototyping team, and I'm zooming in from San Francisco. Now, let me share my screen and take us through a few more. For number 37, prototyping has fixing interaction. This is a bug fix for mouse enter and mouse leave. As you can see, these interactions used to fire off on every single mouse movement. Now we fix them up so they do as they should. They only trigger once per action. Next, number 38 is the more lively positioned edit modal. This makes interaction modals a bit more predictable. When you're editing or creating interaction, the modal will appear on mouse up instead of mouse down, and they'll appear anchored to the head of noodles. Now you can prototype with less fuss on the canvas. Now for some live updates. For number 39, we have shift to hide the edit modal. We noticed that when prototyping, sometimes the interaction modal was a little bit in the way. Now, whenever you hit shift with an interaction modal open, you could temporarily hide the modal. Now you can take a peek at the rest of your flow whenever you need to. Number 40 is indicating multiple actions on the canvas. When you have more than one action set on an object, for actions like set variable or link actions, we'll now add a little shadow to the interactions canvas indicator. So you can now know that these interactions are doing more than one thing. And another update we have is follow active frame. If you've ever gotten lost in a prototype, we have a new inline preview feature to help with that. So I hit shift space to launch the inline preview. I see this new menu and I hit follow active frame. When follow active frame is enabled, your interactions in the inline preview will pan the canvas to the frame shown in the prototype. Now it's easier to go through your prototypes and debug them. And finally, our last little big update in prototyping and the star of the prototyping show, number 42, a sticky scrolling improvement. Now, sticky scrolling can be set on any node or descendant of an overflowing frame. This means that objects can now scroll and then stick for a period of time before they scroll again. That's it for me. I'll pass it back to you, Miggy.
Thank you, Chia. Wow, I can't believe we had those 42 little big updates. I'm so glad that you can all join us in for this announcement. We're super grateful to have you all here. These and updates are inspired by the feedback that the community provides. So make sure you let us know which ones are your favorite and what you would like to see next. So if there's something that's like little, that's kind of annoying you in your day-to-day, let us know. We'll be happy to take a look and fix that. Amazing. All right. So if you joined late or you would like more resources, you want another recap over the things that we covered today, you want to check out the links that we posted in the chat. You can find also the updates on social. You can also get the community file, which is now live. All 42 of the updates are published in this file. You can get it at figma.com/@Figma. Look for the little big updates weekly. You can play it right from there and get a quick recap. So then this way you will be in the know and feel free to share with your colleagues and teammates. So then that way their lives could be made just a little bit better. Also, be sure to check out future live streams at figma.com/events and share ideas that you may have for future events. If there's something you'd like to see, there's some content you'd like to see, if there's a topic that you just want to learn about, please send those requests to community@figma.com. But before we leave, I would like to give big shout outs to Katie, Rashawn, Jessica, Tim, Noah, Bursibel, and Chia for presenting today, and to our product and design and engineering teams that bring these updates to life. And a special shout out to you all for joining us today. We hope at least one of these updates will make you smile, make your day a little bit better. And as always, happy designing.